Think your favorite celebrity chef has earned that coveted culinary school diploma? You'll be surprised to learn that quite a few of them didn't graduate from a culinary school. Does that mean they aren't chefs? Well, technically no, because being a chef doesn't require a degree, but you'll note that a lot of these chefs, I mean cooks or whatever, go out of their way to assure folks they are not chefs, even though they probably still are. Hotheaded celebrity chef Gordon Ramsay has created quite a culinary and media empire for himself. The star of many television hits like Hell's Kitchen and MasterChef has also penned multiple cookbooks, as well as his own autobiography. Ramsay had done all of this while maintaining a string of restaurants that span the globe, including locations in Las Vegas, Atlantic City, France, and Singapore. He has been awarded highly coveted Michelin stars for several of his restaurants in the UK. Not too shabby for a former footballer who didn't even attend culinary school. That's right, Ramsay studied hotel management in college, but really earned his place in the restaurant world by training under world-famous chefs like Marco Pierre White. Ramsay's perseverance and can-do, abrasive attitude even translates into his home life.
None of you are working as a team! Where's the lamb sauce?
Ramsay boasted to The Telegraph that he doesn't intend to leave his fortune to his five children, all of whom receive modest allowances and are not permitted to fly with him in first class. Culinary superstar Rachel Ray would be the first to admit that she is not a chef, but a cook. As Ray told ABC News, "I'm not a chef, and that's fine. I don't bake, I don't do things the right way, I chop an onion wrong, and I'm teaching people how to do it, all that stuff." Her audience certainly doesn't seem to mind. To become the first ever non-chef to get her own show on Food Network, 30 Minute Meals, Ray learned her trade by watching her mom manage restaurants throughout her youth and following suit herself in upstate New York. A stint at a local gourmet food shop led to Ray teaching her down-to-earth 30-minute style classes, which were spied by a local television station that offered her a spot. Countless cookbooks, product lines, a monthly magazine, charities, and a daily major network talk show later, Rachel Ray doesn't show any signs of slowing down.
Measuring to a cook is like putting a bird in a cage.
A couple of things might surprise you about the king of Flavortown, Guy Fieri. For one, he wasn't born Guy Fieri, but Guy Ferry. He changed it to Fieri to honor his Italian grandfather. Second, he is not a professionally trained chef. Fieri attended the University of Nevada in Las Vegas, where he earned his degree in hospitality management. Looking up to his idol, Emeril Lagasse, Fieri had set his sights on becoming a Food Network personality, while honing his kitchen skills in chain restaurants like California's Louise's Trattoria. His first try to score with the network was a miss, but his second attempt was his big payday when he was crowned victor of the second season of Food Network Star in 2006.
This thing is righteous!
Thank you.
Dude.
Fieri has parlayed that win into a culinary empire, including cookbooks, multiple restaurant locations around the world, and television shows like Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Celebrity chef and restaurateur Tom Colicchio has enjoyed many accolades in his career. While working at NYC's Mondrian, Food & Wine magazine named him one of the best new chefs in America. His famed Manhattan restaurant, Gramercy Tavern, earned him the James Beard Foundation's Best Chef New York Award in 2000. This was followed by another James Beard Award in 2002 for Colicchio's restaurant, Kraft, which was named Best New Restaurant of the Year.
To run a great restaurant, it takes a lot of passion, a lot of knowledge, and just a real commitment to quality and to make people happy.
Colicchio's Kraft and Witchcraft restaurants now appear all over New York, Los Angeles, and Las Vegas. When not running his restaurant empire, Colicchio finds time to host the wildly successful cooking competition show, Top Chef. And he did all of that without a culinary degree. Daunted by the Culinary Institute of America's requirement that an applicant should have already worked at two restaurants, Colicchio decided to go to work. He worked in restaurant and hotel kitchens throughout New Jersey while studying cookbooks by Jacques Pepin. He cooked his way up into the Manhattan restaurant scene and landed a gig at the lauded Quilted Giraffe. His time there led to more restaurants on the East Coast and in France, cementing his way to his fame-making position at Mondrian. Lifestyle queen Martha Stewart is sitting pretty on top of a multimedia empire and fortune reportedly worth over $1 billion. Her cookbooks, food and lifestyle magazines, websites, household products, and syndicated cooking shows are enjoyed the world over. And not only has this lifestyle dynamo always made it seem effortless, she's also done it all without a culinary degree. As a teen in New Jersey, Stewart worked as a fashion model, later attending Barnard College, where she earned her degree in European and architectural history. She worked as a Wall Street stockbroker until moving to Connecticut, where she taught herself to cook using Julia Child's Mastering the Art of French Cooking. A successful catering company made way for her foray into books, like Martha Stewart's Christmas. Her brand began to blossom into the behemoth it is today when it went public in 1999. Paula Deen's down-home Southern recipes made her a Food Network staple for over a decade. Deen's recipes may not have been the channel's healthiest, but her eager fan base gobbled them up, along with her cookbooks and self-named magazine. Deen not only didn't attend culinary school, but also got her career started later in life. After a divorce, she relocated with her sons to Savannah, Georgia, where she started a local bagged lunch catering business. The business led to her first restaurant, The Lady, followed by a larger location called The Lady and Sons. Cookbooks followed, the Food Network called, and Deen and family enjoyed tremendous success, until numerous scandals caused her to lose most of her lucrative endorsements, as well as her television contracts and publishing deals.
New trouble for celebrity chef Paula Deen. She lost her TV show on Friday. Now key sponsors are looking at their options.
Through it all, Deen still perseveres. She released her own online network in 2014 and competed on Dancing with the Stars in 2015. Her latest show, Positively Paula, airs nationwide. Mario Batali also rose to culinary fame without a traditional culinary pedigree. Though he attended the famed Le Cordon Bleu in London, he never finished his degree, opting instead to work under famed London chef Marco Pierre White. He cooked throughout Europe and Italy before embarking for NYC. After finding initial success with his very first restaurant, Poe, Batali's flagship restaurant, Bobbo, would go on to be named 1998's Best New Restaurant by the James Beard Foundation. He donned his now trademarked ponytailed hair and orange Crocs for his first television cooking show, Molto Mario, and continued opening successful restaurants across NYC, the US, and the world. Batali penned numerous successful cookbooks and launched a line of packaged Italian pantry foods. Most of this success came to a grinding halt, of course, amidst a harassment scandal in 2017. Batali stepped away from his business ventures, was dismissed as a host of ABC's The Chew, and his product line now donates proceeds to women's charities as they transition to new branding. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more mashed videos about TV chefs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.